video, I have built and reviewed the first part of our Lego Harry Potter Hogwarts castle. Now let's continue to build the rest of the castle. The next section of the build, we will be starting to build the second half of our castle. We will be making this section of the castle, which is the base structure and the ground floor of the other half of our castle. This includes the potion room and the chess game room. Let's build. Progress we've made in the last section of our build, which is the base structure and a few little rooms of the second half of our castle. Other than that, we have a little bonus build on the side, and we've added one more minifigure to the set. Let's now have a look at the details together. This is what we have made in the last section of the build. I hope you've enjoyed a little stop motion building clip. We've added our last minifigure in this section, which is our wizard Salazar, a deep green gown with metallic chain printed on his torso and legs, a two-part cape with a high collar. His big beard is a softer silicone material, and he's holding a wand. Let's have a look at the little bonus build in this section, which is a little bit of the Hagrid's hut and yard. It's very miniature scaled. We don't have any doors or windows we can open, but you can see quite a lot of details with different colored bricks and shapes used to add to the texture of the build. It's not just simply putting cylinder pieces around to create the round surface. So each panel is clicked on individually around the disc at the bottom, and each piece has a different texture. The melon patch is also very, very cute, simply put together with the orange stud and the green flower piece on the top. So the main build we've made in this section is the base structure of the other half of our castle. Externally, very similar to the other section, we've used the large mountain pieces to create the main structure and added a lot of rectangle and triangle pieces in the light grey and olive green to create rocks and greenery. First little room we've built is the room of requirements. Quite a lot going on in this section given the limited space. You can see the vanishing cabinet at the back made with these black pieces. Skeleton prints on the wall, which are all stickers, but the main details of this room are all created by Lego bricks, and there's quite a lot to see in this section. Now let's move on to the potion classroom. Also large stickers on the wall setting the background scene. However, most of the details in this room are also created by Lego bricks. Shelves all the way around the back and side wall with different colored potions created by colorful transparent studs, a few tables and little chairs, and a very pretty purple potion bottle used here. You can see the potion container at the back of the room, which actually is quite large comparing to the microfigures. So if I put a microfigure down, you can see it's massive proportionally. Turning around here, There's a little space here, which is the room with a mirror of Erised, a gold 2x1 tile in the middle with a mirror sticker on it. Quite a good looking sticker. Torches and fires next to the mirror for some extra details. Moving on to the next section, another awesome room, which is our chessboard room. Also a large sticker on the wall representing the background scene, but the chess room itself is also quite well presented with the Lego bricks. Navy blue and white bricks creating the chessboard, and a few different shaped bricks representing the chess pieces, including two plain black and white micro figures representing the kings. The next little room we will go through is the We Need Keys room. Not too much going on here. The main pattern is represented by the large stickers with flying keys. However, we do have a few transparent 2x1 tiles with the flying key stickers on them for a more 3D representation. Also a plain brown paintbrush clipped on the ground. There's a tiny space behind the We Need Keys room here, just under the mountain. Instead of leaving it empty, there's actually a little bit of details we can see. A few stems of devil snares in this section, which is quite a nice detail to see. I guess not too much more you can do with this section. Now moving on to the final section of our Lego Harry Potter Hogwarts castle. We will be building the castle structure above this base we've just made, which includes another major building, the viaduct entrance complex, and stone bridges connecting different parts of the castle. We'll also be adding quite a few interior details to the castle. So it's this highlighted section here we will be building, and you can see the little scenes and details of what we will be making soon. After that, our whole Lego Harry Potter Hogwarts castle will be completed. Very, very exciting. Then we can go through the details together. Let's build. What a wonderful project. This is massive and I had heaps of fun building the set. It's actually quite hard to estimate how long it took me to build this set because I replaced most of the speed building section with stop motion videos, so it took a lot longer than it normally would to put this set together. But let me tell you, this is pretty much what I've been doing every day for the past week or so. I loved every second of it, and now I have to decide exactly where to display this massive castle. Anyway, let's now have a look at the details of the rest of the castle together. This is our completed LEGO Harry Potter Hogwarts Castle set. It's truly massive. In the last section of the build, we've built this half of the castle connecting with the building we've completed in the last section. It's actually barely connected. It's very, very lightly connected with a couple of little slots. So technically, it's actually just two pieces placed together. I guess it does make sense given that it is maybe too big to be moved around as one piece. In this section, we have made the last minifigure of our set, completing the display plate for the four houses of the Hogwarts school. The last minifigure we have made is Rowena. Deep navy blue gown with silver metallic print on the gown. It is a double-faced minifigure, and you can see the metallic head accessory on her forehead. In the last section, we have also made another little bonus build on the side, which is a miniature scaled Whopping Willow. It's actually quite detailed given the scale of the build. All the branches can be rotated 360 degrees and each individual branch can be adjusted to the angle that you wish. There's also a super miniature vehicle that we are to place on the top of our branches. I think definitely another very nice bonus build on top of our Hagrid's hut and yard. We've already looked at the left-hand side of the castle, so now we have built the right-hand side of the castle, including the stone bridges, the viaduct complex, another smaller bridge connecting the two towers. The stone bridge connecting the two sides of the castle is quite firmly slotted in. I think it's actually a tiny bit slanted on an angle. You can't really tell from here, but if you look at it in person, there's like a 5-degree slant. So it's not completely vertical to our viaduct complex. It might bother some perfectionists. The major building we have made in this section of the build is definitely the viaduct complex. Externally, very similar to how the Great Hall is built. We've got similar texture posts on the walls, similar type of window panels. I think a very grand scene with the bridge leading up to the main entrance. Again, we have the very beautiful stained glasses panels on the main wall, including the circular piece on the top of the building. Torches on either side of the entrance with the two large wooden doors that also opens inwards. There are four cylinder towers on this building. These two in particular does contain quite a lot of texture. There are a lot of little panels making the external wall, and we can see the cylinder window pieces all the way around the two towers with the printed window tiles, which is very elegant looking. The top cylinder is also quite complicated with a lot of texture and panels creating the details. Looking from the side, another stained glass piece and the same printed pattern on the little windows on the sides. Turning it around, you can see quite a lot of detail on this main level, which is what we made in the last section. And these two towers here are a little bit simpler in the way they structure. It's basically all the curved pieces stacking together with a few cylinder pieces joining together to make the tower. I think this is a very beautiful scene from this angle with the bridge leading into the very high ceiling grand room with the two large doors. Again, very, very beautiful stained glasses panels. I think one of the most attractive feature of this set. We can see quite a lot of details in this section. Firstly, this little section is a Gryffindor common room with a few red couches around, a chair at the back, and a large fireplace looking very cozy. This side of the building is an area for the library. I think very well represented with the Lego bricks. Relatively simple structure with a few one by one bricks stacked together to create stacked books. But because of how The table is structured with the shelving in the middle, table surfaces on either side. I think that makes the library area very recognizable. A few stickers on the post as decorations. Turning around again, a little bridge connecting these two buildings. Not too much to see here otherwise. Then we can see this section just above the chessboard room. Very few details we can see on this level. It's pretty much an empty space. Some decorations on the wall that are stickers, which is the writing from the Chamber of Secrets. There's another sticker here on the post. I didn't really know what it is, but I did some research. Apparently, this is supposed to represent the activated door to the Room of Requirements. Next level up, we have two lovely spaces on the top level. Firstly, definitely a very striking super pink room, which is Umbridge's office. Super dark pink lamp on the top with brown tables and chairs and four white studs on the wall representing her decorative plates. And this area here is the Transfiguration classroom. We don't have a huge amount of details made with Lego bricks in this room. We've got a few rows of tables, magnifying glasses, and a few transparent pieces on the shelf representing bottles and jars. Other than that, it's pretty much relying on the patterns on the wall, which are stickers. This tower here also has quite a lot of texture, very similar building technique used as the other two main towers in this section of the building. I probably could have done a better job trying to straighten the one by one tiles a little bit to make them look a bit more neat. From this angle here, this section is quite plain. We don't have a lot of details at all. I do like the pointy oval shaped entrance, the matching torches on either sides of the entrance. Other than that, there isn't too much to see. We've got a combination of smooth brick surfaces and brick patterned pieces used throughout different parts of the castle to create that aged stone texture, which I think works very well. Again, I had a lot of fun building this set. It's very, very satisfying creating this from scratch. A massive project, but I think it looks really great. Probably not as much detail as a lot of the Harry Potter fans would have hoped. Not everything is included in the scene, not everything is to scale or even in position, but I still had a lot of fun creating this project. I hope you've enjoyed this review video and my very first attempt of making stop motion speed building videos. I really enjoyed it myself, so I will continue to make stop motion building videos in all my future review videos. Thanks for watching again. See you next time, everyone. Bye.